Boom, boom. Boom, boom.
Hello, everybody. I'm Michael Schiavello, coming to you from my home in Melbourne, Australia. Welcome to One Championship at Home. I am joined today by a guy I've known for more than 20 years, and I must have commentated over 50 of his matches. He's a 10-time world kickboxing and Muay Thai champion. He is a living legend in every sense of the word. I'm talking about the one, the only, John Wayne Parr. Wayne, great to see you, brother.
Mate, how you been?
I have been fantastic. How are you been? Happy, healthy, always with that big Wayne Parr smile.
Yeah, all good. I got new mats for my gym, so I'm very excited. So me and the family make up excuses just to go to the gym to train, just so we can use the new mats. So it's really cool.
It's good to see you, mate.
Yeah, don't want to get a cabin fever either. It's been inside, locked up all the time, so it's nice to get out into the gym and still try and be a little bit active.
This is the first time I get to officially congratulate you for signing with the biggest martial arts promotion in the world. You're on the big stage now. It's One Championship. Welcome aboard, mate. How does it feel?
Ooh, I'm so happy. It's been something I've been wanting to do for a very long time. And then finally here. So you little ripper. I'm so excited. I'm very thankful and appreciative, Mr. Chetri, for giving me the opportunity to come on board. What a promotion. I've got to go there with Lockie and for the Singapore event and was absolutely blown away. And even though it was an indoor event, it was still amazing. Just the staff and how professional everybody was. Seeing yourself as well. And then, and then to be amongst it, to be one of the boys now is really, really cool. So I'm very happy.
My mind is racing with the possibility of so many matchups, but there are some that really appeal to me, and I'll mention a few here, because there's trilogies, there's rematches, there's revenge factors, there's quadrilogies, if that's such a thing. Let me name a few here. There are very few people in the world who can be dubbed as living legends. You are one of them. Another one is another old foe of yours, Yodson Clay Fairtex. You fought Yod 3 times, and I remember you saying years ago that every time you fought Yod, it aged you by 10 years. So judging by that, you should be about 75 years old right now.
Yeah.
But what are your thoughts on perhaps a fourth match against Yod?
Yeah, geez, that'd be crazy. I did a documentary called Blessed Venom, and I went to Fairtex, and me and Yod had a little interview, and I asked him, I said, are you sick of fighting me yet? He goes, I'm so sick of fighting you. I said, I'm sick of fighting you also.
I know another, also a contender alumni of yours, Jabir Askarov, is also with One Super Series. But there's one more name I want to throw out there. And this is one that since your announcement was made that you'd signed with One, so many fans came on Twitter, on Instagram, on Facebook, and they said they want this one. It would really be throwing you in the deep end, JW. John Wayne Parr versus, can you guess it?
Is it from Holland by any chance?
Oh, yeah. Good chance. Good chance.
Yeah,
Mickey Holtzkin. Mickey Holtzkin.
He's a man. I got nothing but respect as well. So he would be my Mary Medicas. I never got the opportunity to fight Raymond. Raymond's one of my buddies. And then I have nothing but respect for Nicky as well. Craziest, awesome, pound for pound guys ever. And even just the fighting, if I can put up a good fight, win, lose, or draw, it's going to be so entertaining. And it's going to be for history books as well. Just know that I've ticked every box on the world stage that I fought. I didn't dodge anybody. So it'd be a great fight. He's amazing. I'd love to test my skills and to get a victory over Nicky. Holy crap. Oh, that'd be so cool. So, but at the same time, I know how hard it's going to be, and I know I have to be on top of my game. But as an excitement factor, I think it's one of those fights where it's like a Mayweather-Pacquiao. It's sort of that much excitement. It'd definitely get a lot of eyes watching and hopefully break some records.
It would be a blockbuster in every sense of the word. JW, I've got to clarify something for the fans, especially those fans that haven't seen most of your career. And you're known as John Wayne Parr. And many people talk to me, you know, new fans of yours that are super excited you signed with One Super Series. They go, oh, I'm so excited to see John. I'm so excited to see John now in One Super Series. Hold on a moment, guys. Got to clarify. His name is not John. John's the nickname. Wayne Parr is the name. John Wayne is the nickname. How did you get the nickname John Wayne?
So when I was in Thailand, everybody has a fight name. Everyone, whether it be the fighter that I was living with at the time called Senkin Noi, and that meant the small candlelight flame. So everything, it was really deep and meaningful. Other guys got names like the 100,000 techniques or just the golden shark or just crazy stuff. So the ties were asking me, what can we call you? You need a name. I said, oh, I don't know. And they said, what's your background? I said, oh, my mum and dad are horse trainers. We were growing up on farms. Oh, so you're like a cowboy. So you're like John Wayne. I'm like, oh, no, that sucks. That's so bad. That's so corny. And then I say, oh, no. And then I got famous. And I was like, oh, now I'm stuck with his name.
Jazzy, your daughter. I hadn't seen Jazzy since she was about 3 years old. And then I saw her in Singapore when Rocky was on the card against Sam May on February 28. And she's an outstanding young woman, but she is also one of the real blossoming talents in the world of Muay Thai. Maybe we might sign her in one super series in 12 or 18 months, but tell us about Jazzy, your daughter. She is doing amazing things.
Yeah, she's doing really well. She had her first fight when she was 8 years old, and there was a little bit of a media scrutiny because of her age, but she didn't get deterred. She stayed the course, and she kept training through all the adversities. And so now she's a role model for all these young up-and-coming, not just females, but males as well. She's got 40,000 followers on her Instagram page. So she obviously is doing the right thing and pushing in a positive direction for martial arts and for kids to just be active. So yeah, she's very, very excited. She's 17 now. And then she has her eyes, hopefully the same with the one just like that. So hopefully she can follow dad's footsteps and cross over onto the big stage and fight on the big shows.
Well, Wayne, Jazzy wouldn't only be joining Dad in one super series, she'd also be joining her boyfriend, Rocky Ogden, for those that don't know. And I've got to say, so your daughter's boyfriend is also a one super series athlete, could be your future son-in-law. You're his trainer.
Yeah.
Is it kind of awkward?
Yeah, that was really cool. Rocky's amazing. As much as the whole father and the boyfriend is always going to be a thing. I've got so much respect for Rocky. He's went to Thailand. He did exactly the same thing that I did when I was his. He's done it even before when I was that age. I went to, when I was 19. He went when he was 16. And his main desire is to become a world star. So and then when they're together, he inspires Jazzy to train harder, and he pushes her, and everything he teaches, I approve of. I think he's that amazing.
Wayne, I want to know what brought you back, mate, because you competed in the biggest boxing match in Australia in 2019 against the legend Anthony Chop Mundine. You beat Anthony Mundine. It was a huge result for your boxing career, where I believe you're 11 or 12-0 in boxing. And then you said that was it. You retired after years of kickboxing, boxing and Muay Thai for so long. What brought you back?
I want to keep making memories, and I keep going on adventures and keep representing Australia and just keep doing what I love. I don't want to just sit and watch the TV and just be bored. I might be older and I might be breaking down, but at the same time, I still have the passion. And I still want to be part of the scene, and it's really cool. It was awesome being with Rocky and being part of his corner and absorbing everything that he was doing. But just the exhilaration of standing across the ring from someone like a Nicky Holson or a Jabbar or a Cosmo, it's quite exhilarating when that bell rings. You can't bottle that excitement. It's something you have to experience to really appreciate.
Well, mate, we started back in 1998 together. 22 years later, we're about to do it all over again. The adventure continues. I can't wait. I know you are jumping out of your skin. Wayne Parr, John Wayne Parr, thanks for joining us, mate. As always, it's been a pleasure, brother.
Hey, thank you so much. Thank you for the opportunity to have a chat. And thank you, Wayne, for signing me. I'm so happy. You.
There you go, folks. The legend, the 10-time World Muay Thai and kickboxing champion, John Wayne Parr, from his home in Queensland. I'm Michael Schiavello at home in Melbourne, Australia. This has been One Championship at Home.
Hey guys, it's Misha Tate. If you want to see more awesome One Championship content, make sure you click that subscribe button. Click it so you don't miss it.